This conference will now be recorded.
Hi everyone, welcome to our webinar on Oracle GoldenGate different monitoring methods and Oracle GoldenGate Veridata. My name is Ashish Agarwal, and I'll be delivering this session to you. So before commencing the session, just I want you to give you an update regarding my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/ashishagarwal_gg. So if you haven't visited the channel, I would request you to do visit the channel and do like, share and subscribe the channel. The channel is dedicated to only GoldenGate related videos. So I would give you 10 seconds to like and subscribe, and then we'll start our session. Okay, so let us start our session now. So this session is about how to monitor Oracle GoldenGate and Veridata. So I have been facing a lot of questions related to how can we monitor Oracle GoldenGate environment, or what are the different ways to monitor Oracle GoldenGate environment? What are different kind of monitoring that could be put on Oracle GoldenGate to monitor it well, so that there are database related issues or performance related issues, everything could be monitored. So that's why I decided to do this webinar. So I'll be discussing about it, and also I'll be discussing about Oracle GoldenGate Veridata as well. So before commencing, just a quick introduction about me. So my name is Ashish Agarwal, for those who don't know me. So I'm expert in Oracle GoldenGate and Oracle Database Rack and all Oracle technologies, and currently I'm also doing on cloud as well. I have 12 plus years of training experience in GoldenGate, so I have been providing trainings and doing these sessions, webinars, live trainings on GoldenGate for last 12 years since 2009. Now I have various high rated courses available like Oracle GoldenGate, Classic Architecture, Microservices, Veridata. I have trained almost now 4,200 plus trainees and taken 140 corporate batches so far. I'm a certified Oracle professional and Oracle GoldenGate certified as well. So I'm blogger, speaker, and I have presented my papers at Oracle Open World. So I have been doing this at a lot of places. I have been associated with a lot of institutes. I provide my sessions on AIU OUG, South Africa, Oracle User Group. So I have been doing this for a long time now. So if you want to reach out to me, these are my details. My email is at ashishagarwalag@gmail.com. If you have any queries, any question, I'm also available on Twitter as well. So you can tweet me your query at Ashish Agarwal AG. Also, you can drop in your comment at youtube.com/ashishagarwal_gg. So let us start our session now. Let us focus for next 60 to 90 minutes. I would request you to keep your mobile phone away for next 60 to 90 minutes. This session is going to be an amazing session for learning. So focus and put your phone away. Also, I request you during the session, for whatever we are discussing, focus on that. If you have any doubts, any questions, there is a chat window available. Post your questions in the chat window. Okay. So today's session agenda, we are going to discuss about different monitoring, Oracle GoldenGate monitoring methods available. Then we'll be discussing about what is Oracle GoldenGate Veridata, how Oracle GoldenGate Veridata compares the data, what is performance metric server, GoldenGate heartbeat table, and OGG monitoring via shell scripting. So before I proceed, let us quickly discuss about Oracle GoldenGate. So what is Oracle GoldenGate, how Oracle GoldenGate works? Let us quickly have a discussion about that. So Oracle GoldenGate architecture, what is Oracle GoldenGate first of all? So GoldenGate is a replication tool which replicates the data from source database to the target database. So whatever changes are happening on source database, they will be replicated to the target database. So GoldenGate is a CDC tool. CDC stands for change data capture. So whatever changes happens onto the source database, those changes are going to be captured by the GoldenGate and will be applied by the GoldenGate process on the target machine. So You have source database, target database. Whatever changes you make to the database, those changes are recorded into the transaction logs of the database. So each database has its own transaction logs. When we talk about Oracle, these transaction logs are called as redo logs or backup of redo logs, which are called as archive logs. Now, in case of non-Oracle database, these transaction logs are called as transaction logs. So GoldenGate is a product which not only works with Oracle, it also works with non-Oracle databases as well. It works with heterogeneous databases. So whatever changes are made to the database, those changes are recorded into the transaction logs. GoldenGate capture process is going to read those changes from the transaction logs, captures only committed transactions, and writes them to the trail file on local machine, which are known as local trail file. So GoldenGate capture process is going to capture only committed transactions and write them to the local trail files. Once the data becomes available into local trail, data pump process reads the data out of your local trail, sends it over TCP/IP network, and writes it to remote trail on the target machine. As soon as data becomes available into remote trail, GoldenGate replicate process will apply it to target database upon reading the remote trail files. So each process in GoldenGate has its own work. So there are three processes involved in GoldenGate replication: capture, pump, and delivery. Capture process captures the data, pump process do the data transfer, and replicate process applies the data. Each process has a source to read from and a target to write to. Capture process source is transaction logs. Target is local trail. Pump process source is local trail. Target is remote trail. Delivery process source is remote trail. Target is target database. GoldenGate works in bi-directional environment as well. So bi-directional, we mean that both the sites can be live. So whatever transactions are happening on site A, they will be replicated to site B. Similarly, whatever transactions are happening on site B, they will be replicated to site A using Oracle GoldenGate. So GoldenGate works in bidirectional environment. I call bidirectional environment as two-way unidirectional with some considerations. Okay, now one thing is, quickly I want to discuss. I discussed that this is Oracle GoldenGate classic architecture. So I have discussed in multiple sessions of mine, like what is GoldenGate classic architecture, microservices, but I see a lot of new faces. So I'll quickly discuss. There are two types of architecture. One is classic architecture in GoldenGate, and second is microservices architecture. So these are the two types of architectures available in Oracle GoldenGate. So classic architecture is command prompt based architecture. It is GGSCI. So when you set up, configure GoldenGate through GGSCI, it is called as classic architecture. So I'll give you a quick overview. So GoldenGate was founded in 1995, and it was named after famous GoldenGate, famous San Francisco bridge called as GoldenGate. So it is called as GoldenGate. In 2009, Oracle overtook it, and since then it is known as Oracle GoldenGate. From 2009 to 2017, there was only one way to configure GoldenGate, and that was through command prompt, GGSCI. Until 2017, it was called as Oracle GoldenGate. In 2017, Oracle renamed it to classic architecture, Oracle GoldenGate classic architecture. And they launched a new architecture of GoldenGate, which is called as microservices architecture. So microservices architecture is GUI based architecture, which allows you to set up, manage, troubleshoot, configure GoldenGate through GUI, and allows for better integration with cloud application. Now the thing is, a lot of people, what they get confused is microservices is similar to OEM. No guys, GUI is one of the feature of microservices. However, there are a lot more capabilities of microservices in GoldenGate. So this is the future of GoldenGate microservices. As of today, the market share of microservices is less, but Oracle is pushing this product very aggressively now. So as of today, it's not like classic architecture is obsolete. You can choose any of the two. When you're setting up GoldenGate in your environment, for your organization, in your personal machine, you can choose any of the two. You can either go with classic or you can go with microservices architecture. So just to give you overview how they look like, the microservices architecture, you might have already seen this classic architecture. So this is how this GUI of microservices, sorry, the GUI of microservices looks like. So you can set up, you can add the extract from here if you want. You can add the replicate, whatever you want to do, you can do from GUI over here. So this is the replicate process if you want to add. Similarly, you have data pump. So data pump of classic has been replaced with distribution server in microservices architecture. So whatever you want to do, you can do through GUI as well in microservices architecture. Okay. So there are two types of architecture. One is classic, second is microservices. So classic is GGSCI based architecture, which allows you to set up, manage, troubleshoot, configure Golden Gate through command prompt. Microservices allows you to do that through GUI as well. Okay. Okay. So now let us discuss about Oracle Golden Gate different monitoring methods. So the question comes, why do we need monitoring? What type of monitoring we need? So the thing here is Golden Gate replication involves three Golden Gate processes, as we see. Capture process, which is also called as extract process, pump process, which is a data mechanism process, delivery process, which is also called as replicated process, which is also called as a replicate process. Okay. Now, there are three Golden Gate processes. So basically, the Golden Gate replication revolves around these three processes: capture, pump, and delivery. If any of the process goes down, your delivery will be, your Golden Gate replication will be stopped. So it is very important for us to monitor Golden Gate in terms of performance. What performance means is, say for example, the lag at the pump or lag at capture or delivery process, if any of the three or all three processes high, ultimately the replication will be delayed. So the first thing could be the processes are running, but they are not able to replicate the data in near real time. So Golden Gate is a near real time replication tool. Guys, one thing, let me make it clear. It's being promoted by Oracle as real time product, but I will say it is a near real time product because real time means there should be 0 second lag, but always it's a product which comes with a few seconds lag. So that's why I always call it as near real time product, near real time replication product. So what does that mean is you have, so each process can have some lag. So lag means the time difference it takes to capture or apply the data. So overall lag will be, say for example, if a transaction gets committed on source database at 10 a.m. and it gets applied on target database at 15 past 10. So overall lag will be 15 minutes in the system. So the lag could arrive if any of the Golden Gate process has a lag. So maybe capture has lag, pump has lag, or delivery has lag. So you need to identify where the lag lies. So what kind of monitoring you have to put if any of the process is down or lag is high, you should have some alerts for that. Similarly, other issue could be processes are completely down. Any of the Golden Gate process is not running. Again, Golden Gate replication will be stuck. Another issue could be on source. So Golden Gate thrives on data integrity as well. So by data integrity, we means that if there are 100 records on source, those 100 records, if Golden Gate needs to replicate, they should be replicated. So Golden Gate applies the data on target database without compromising any data integrity in any of the environment. So say for example, now Golden Gate is a tool and issues can come. We cannot say no product or no tool in this world is error free. So say for example, your Golden Gate replication is running for 3 years, 4 years. There is a huge table. In that table, you have 100,000 records. Now, due to some reason, there has been some data discrepancy. Those data discrepancy can come due to some data corruption, lock corruption, or Golden Gate replication not done properly, or it could be the on target database the records were deleted manually. So there is some data discrepancy. Like on source you have 100,000 records, on target you have 99,000 records. So there is that discrepancy of 1,000 records. So that also you need to identify. So database in sync performance, in sync issues should be monitored. Along with that, Golden Gate performance should be monitored as well. So let us discuss Oracle Golden Gate different monitoring methods now. So for monitoring Oracle Golden Gate environment, there are different options available. While monitoring Golden Gate, there are two critical things we have to look at. What are those critical things? First is database in sync monitoring. So Golden Gate is a replication tool. It syncs target database with source database. Now we have to ensure that the committed data, which is present in source, should be replicated to target. So data sync is very important. We have to ensure that source and target databases are in sync. So whatever data gets committed on source database, that should be replicated to the target database without any issue. So we have to ensure whatever records have been committed, those should be present on the target. That is one thing. Second thing is Oracle Golden Gate performance. This involves Oracle Golden Gate overall performance of the environment, which involves lag, as I told, OGG process status, that means the processes are up and running, monitoring OGG environment to ensure the processes are up and running. So I would classify it into these two important things. So let us discuss about database in sync monitoring. How do you monitor database in sync monitoring? So Oracle Golden Gate Veridata is a monitoring tool which is used to identify data discrepancies between source and target. So say for example, you have 100,000 records on source and 99,000 records on target. So what Veridata can do for you is it can identify the data discrepancies between source and target, and it basically compares your source records with target records. So everything is compared record by record. So if any of the column between two databases is again not in sync, what it will do is it will report that as a discrepancy. So apart from row count, so right now what is happening is there are a lot of cloud migrations going on. I have been facing this question for a long time now, and that's why I decided to do webinar on this. I have faced almost like 200 queries in last 3 months about the same question, how to monitor Golden Gate. So why they want to monitor Golden Gate like here is, so what is happening is organizations are upgrading their environment from on-prem to cloud. So upon migration from on-prem to cloud, they want to ensure whether the data between source and target is in sync or not. Now, one of the way or one of the not good way, but just as an indicative measure, you can check the count of the rows. Like say, for example, you have migrated 200 tables from on-prem to cloud. So one of the option is if you don't do record by record comparison, one of the ways to check the count. So if the count matches, then it can give you the indicative measure that your source and target are in sync. It won't give you the exact measure, but yeah, at least you can have indicative measure that your source and target are in sync. Because see, count will only show you the count, but if say for example some updates are not applied by Golden Gate from source to target, so you have 10 rows in DEPT 11 table, out of those 10 rows the count is same, but you updated a row, still the count will be same, but that update is not applied on target, so that again will give you an issue, right? So that is why it is very important for you to do row by row comparison as well, column by column comparison as well. So what Veridata does is It is a monitoring tool which does the data discrepancy check. So Veridata, as the name suggests, it verifies the data for you. So whatever rows are there on source, it will compare it with target database, and if any discrepancy is there among the columns, among the rows, it will list down those discrepancies, and it can also repair those discrepancies as well for you if needed. So if it identifies any discrepancies and you want to get your source and target database in sync, Veridata can do that for you. So I have a blog related to Veridata as well. So you can go through the blog. I'll share the link in the chat session. Along with that, Veridata I'll discuss in detail during this session as well. Okay. Now, what are the other options available? Other option is you can write your own shell scripts. So Veridata does database in sync monitoring for you. Now, other option is OGG performance monitoring. So before I proceed, another thing Veridata can do for you is what? So that is another major important aspect. So the thing is, you may say, Ashish, so Veridata doesn't require any downtime as well. So your source application can run and you can run your Veridata check without any issues. Now you may ask, Ashish, how come, say for example, you started the Veridata job. So Veridata, you have to start at a particular time, right? And say for example, at that time, you started the Veridata job on both source and target at the same time at 10 a.m. Now, when you started the Veridata job at 10 a.m., just before you started Veridata job on source, there were 100 rows. And you did one update between source at source. Now, before it could be applied on target database, you started the Veridata job. Before the update which you did, before it could be started, before it could be applied by the Golden Gate replicate process, you started your Veridata job. So what happens with Veridata is Veridata keeps check of in-flight rows. So this row will be in flight. This update will be in flight, basically, right? So you did the update, and before the record could, before this transaction could be applied on target, Veridata job on target was started. So it will note down all the in flight rows, and after certain amount of time, you can define that timing, and only after certain amount of time it will report them as out of sync. So the major advantage with Veridata is it keeps track of whatever rows are in flight, and you don't need any downtime with Veridata. So again, as I mentioned, we'll be discussing about Veridata in detail. Now, how can you monitor OGG performance? So for OGG performance monitoring, you can write your own shell scripts. So you can write your own shell script, which is run as a job monitoring Oracle Golden Gate. The alerts could be configured if any of the OGG process goes down or abandoned. So also alerts can be sent to stakeholders if the lag in Golden Gate environment goes beyond agreed threshold. So as I mentioned to you earlier, Golden Gate performance is measured with each process. So if, say for example, extract lag is high, it will subsequently hamper your data pump performance, and also it will hamper your Golden Gate, it will hamper your replicate performance as well. Same with other processes as well. So what you can do is you can write your own shell scripts, and so you can identify, first of all, you can definitely discuss with the business what is the agreed threshold in your environment. So say for example, some environment are critical. In that case, you can keep the threshold as 2 minutes. So that means that if any of the Golden Gate process threshold, the lag goes beyond 120 seconds, in that case, alerts will be sent out to all the stakeholders. Another possibility is if the process goes down, if the process goes stopped or abandoned, again, A critical alert should be goes down to all the stakeholders. So you can configure the email alerts for that, and email alerts will be sent out to all the stakeholders so that action could be taken and everyone is aware that Golden Gate replication is down or may not be working due to this issue. So you can write your own shell scripts. For that, of course, for sending out the email, you need to have SMTP server configured. So the prerequisite for configuring for this shell scripting of Golden Gate alert is you need to have SMTP server configured and you need to write the shell scripting for that. Okay. Now another option is you can monitor your Oracle Golden Gate environment through OEM, Oracle Enterprise Manager. So Oracle Enterprise Manager is just the monitoring tool. So how you can do that is there is a separate plugin which comes. So install OGG plugin for Oracle Golden Gate to set up alerts and alarms in OEM. So what you are doing using shell scripts, same thing you can do through OEM as well if needed. So you can set up your alerts, or you can set up your alerts and alarms in OEM, and the alerts will be sent out to stakeholders. So if any of the process goes abandoned or lack process threshold, then email alerts are sent out to threshold. So the prerequisite to set up this OEM is you need to have Golden Gate plugin set up for Oracle Golden Gate. You can download it from OTN. And also you need to set up these alerts or alarms manually. So you need to have business agreement for both these methods. How much should be defined as how much lag should be defined as critical for your environment. Then there is one more product in Golden Gate family, which is called as Oracle Golden Gate Monitor. I'm not sure if you have heard about it or not. So Oracle Golden Gate Monitor is a separate license tool which falls under Oracle Management Pack product list. It allows you to monitor multiple Oracle Golden Gate environment. So with monitor is, it allows, so if you have multiple Golden Gate environments in your environment, what monitor can do for you is monitor can identify, you can configure all the Golden Gate environments from multiple servers in a single monitor server, and you can monitor all those Golden Gate environments through that particular Golden Gate monitor installed on some intermediate server. So the advantage with monitor is monitor can monitor several Golden Gate environments at one place. The downside is it's a separate license product, and it's my personal experience, I would suggest. I won't say take it as a statement, but as per my personal suggestion, monitor doesn't add much value to your work. Like whatever you can achieve through this, what we discussed, shell script, OEM, monitor doesn't add much value. Another thing is utility, that means the GUI of OGG monitor is not that good. Okay. Then you can also monitor. So from starting with 12.3 Golden Gate, from 12.3 Golden Gate version onwards, you also have performance metric server introduced as well. So prior to 12.2, this wasn't there. From 12.3 Golden Gate version onwards, Golden Gate launched performance metric server in both classic and microservices architecture. So performance metric server allows you to graphically monitor Oracle Golden Gate processes. So this is a huge addition to core product and allows end users to monitor their Oracle Golden Gate environment in near real time. On the microservices architecture, this service is enabled automatically and can be used per deployment basis. So I'll show you how performance metric server looks like. So performance metric server, it looks like this. So you can monitor your Golden Gate environment. It will show you what all processes you have configured in your environment, what all processes are running well, what all processes are down. So say for example, so all these processes are running. If any of the Golden Gate processes are down, it will show you like this. So it shows you what all Golden Gate processes are running in your Golden Gate environment. So green means they are running. Red means it is abandoned or stopped. So it gives you the graphical overview. It is very good addition to the core product. It also gives you like status change overview, monitoring commands, everything you can find from here. Now say for example, if I want to go through, if I want to understand about particular process, what it is doing and how it is connecting. So if I want to check the process performance, it can give, it can graphically give me what is the process performance, what is the process ID, how much IO it is consuming. Everything could be seen in detail. Similarly, IO writes, IO reads, you can monitor Oracle Golden Gate performance in real time. Then you can also see thread performance. So it can give you the thread performance as well graphically. Along with that, you can find your status and configuration over here. So what changes happened at what time, which process, which trail file it is writing data to, every information you can get over here. Similarly, you can get statistics, trail file details, everything you can get from performance metric server over here. So performance metric server is a huge addition to Oracle Golden Gate. You can monitor Oracle Golden Gate over the screen. So the major advantage again is with performance metric server is, say for example, you have 10 people working in your environment. Now with Golden Gate, you don't want to give OS level access. So what you can do is you can graphically monitor Oracle Golden Gate. You can give the access to that server should be in network. So through graphically, you can monitor your Oracle, through GUI basically, you can monitor Oracle Golden Gate environment and understand which processes are running, which processes are down. Okay. Then also you have got Heartbeat table introduced from Golden Gate. So Heartbeat table was available in fact in 11G as well. I think it was available in Golden Gate 10G as well. But from 12.2 onwards, you have got feature of automatic Heartbeat table. So automatic Heartbeat table means that the Heartbeat table gets created automatically in your Golden Gate environment. That means that you don't need to create it manually. You just have to run one command at Heartbeat table and automatically it will be created. So Heartbeat tables, procedures and triggers related to it, everything will be cleared. Everything will be created automatically. So Golden Gate Heartbeat, automatic Heartbeat table was introduced in Oracle Golden Gate version 12.2 and is the built-in Heartbeat table that provides end-to-end lag views without having to manually implement your own Heartbeat table. So what happens is, why this Heartbeat table is really very important. The thing is, how do you check the lag in Golden Gate environment? To check the lag, you execute the command lag in process name, right? Now that lag, when you see, it only gives you the last processed transaction lag. It doesn't give you any historical lag. Now, say for example, application team comes to you and say that the Golden Gate lag was down, the replication didn't happen properly on Friday 8 a.m. Today is Monday and right now there is no lag in the system, but you don't have any historical lag to check their claim or to identify whether there was any issue really, right? So to overcome that, you have got this Golden Gate Heartbeat table. So Golden Gate Heartbeat table allows you to monitor the history lag. So what if the Heartbeat table is implemented, you can check, you can verify the details You can go to the table. So this lag is stored in the table at the database level. So you can go at the table level, verify was there any lag on Friday. If there was any lag on Friday, you can check your the claim of application team will be verified. And if there was no lag, then you can discuss with them and say that no, there was no lag at Golden Gate. There must have been some other issue, which you can definitely then work on to resolve. But Golden Gate level, you will be clear whether there was any lag or not. So introduced in Golden Gate release 12.2 is the built-in heartbeat table feature that provides end-to-end replication lag views without having to manually implement your own heartbeat table. So prior to 12.2, you had to implement your own heartbeat table. So after creating the heartbeat table, how do you add? To add the heartbeat table, you use the command add heartbeat table. The add heartbeat table under GGSCI, upon adding parameter configuration to globals parameter file. When using the GGSCI lag command, so this is the problem and why do we need heartbeat table? So lag we can see using lag command as well at GGSCI, but it's only the indicative measure. So when using the GGSCI lag command, only the latest lag is reported within a 1 second resolution, providing the last reported lag. This isn't trustworthy and nothing significant could be derived out of it. So that's why your heartbeat table has been introduced. So I have a blog available related to this heartbeat table as well. So this is how your heartbeat table looks like. So what you can do is once your heartbeat table is implemented at the database level, so I'll paste this heartbeat table blog for you. So this is how this heartbeat table looks like. So what happens is it tells you what is source and what is target. So from where this data is coming from and where it is getting applied to. And at this particular moment, like at 30 past 1, what was the lag? It was 5 seconds. Then at this particular date and this particular time, the lag was 6 seconds. Similarly, at this time, the lag was 2.7 seconds. At this particular time, the lag was 8.72 seconds. So you can identify, this shows you the overall lag, how much time it took for a transaction. So what happens is in a heartbeat table, a artificial heartbeat is sent from the source to target database. Artificial heartbeat is sent from source to target database. So how whatever time it takes for that particular artificial heartbeat to apply, so that time is reported over here. So you can identify at what particular time the lag is high. So say for example, the application team is complaining that at this particular time lag was high. So you can verify for next 60 heartbeats. So by default, the heartbeat is sent every 1 minute. So that's why you can see at 1:30, at 1:31, 1:32, and 1:33, the heartbeat was sent. And the lag during that time has been reported, whatever the lag was. So the heartbeat table will list down what was the lag at particular time. You can verify the claim of application team upon verifying the time, and then it can confirm to you what was the lag at that particular time. So heartbeat table stores the history lag as well as it gives you the exact lag, which can be trustworthy. Okay. Now let me take few questions which are there in chat. So Anil is asking, what is integrated architecture? So I have discussed guys about this multiple times. So there is no architecture called as integrated, guys. There are only two types of architecture in Golden Gate. One is classic, second is microservices. Now, in there are multiple types of extract and replicates. So there are two types of extract. integrated extract and classic extract. Similarly, you have multiple type of replicates like integrated replicate, coordinated replicate, non-integrated or classic replicate, and then you have parallel replicate, which has been introduced from Golden Gate version 12.3 onwards. So parallel replicate is again of two types: parallel integrated replicate and parallel non-integrated replicate. So inside classic architecture, you can configure either integrated extract or classic extract if supported. Similarly, you can configure any of these four types of replicates, either integrated replicate, coordinated replicate, non-integrated replicate, or you can configure your parallel replicate. Similarly, inside microservices architecture, you can configure your integrated extract or classic extract or integrated replicate or any other available supported replicate. So integrated is type of extract or replicate. It's not an architecture, guys. Okay, so what is integrated extract or classic extract? So integrated extract is the latest, is available from, I should not say latest, yeah, it is a latest type of extract. So it is available only with Oracle database. Classic is available with Oracle as well as non-Oracle database. So integrated extract integrates with database and works with log mining server. However, classic extract directly captures the data from transaction logs of the database. Integrated replicate is available with Golden Gate version 12.1. Coordinated replicate is available from Golden Gate version 12.2. Classic replicate is available since beginning and it is still available. And parallel replicate is available from Golden Gate version 12.3 onwards. Parallel replicate is getting very popular now. Parallel replicate support is getting increased and it is very, means parallel replicate performance is almost, as per my experience, as per my test, it is almost 5 times better than your contemporary replicates. So parallel replicate performance is really very high. So the answer to the question, Anil, I hope it is answered. So there are two types of architecture in Golden Gate, classic and microservices. Under classic architecture, you have different types of extract and different types of replicate. Similarly, same with microservices, you have different types of extracts and replicates available. Now, this is the valid question. Many people get confused about it. The reason being, what Oracle has done is, they have renamed the existing architecture to classic, and again existing the traditional extract to classic as well. So that's why that confusion has come. Okay, now there is one question which says, it's better, can we get relative comparison like when to use which tool, paid version? So nothing. So okay, so whatever we have discussed related to this today, only Veridata is a tool, separate license tool, or Monitor is a separate license tool. Again, it depends. If you are ready to buy the license, you can go with Monitor. So it depends what type. So what shell scripts can do, what OEM can do, Monitor is doing the same task for you. Now, if you want to monitor it graphically, and if you want to use some Oracle product, and if you are ready to buy licenses for it, in that case, go with Monitor. Otherwise, same task you can achieve definitely when you do it through shell scripting or OEM. There are some manual work involved in that. If you use Monitor, everything Monitor can take care of it. But definitely, this is a separate tool. Now, Veridata is a completely separate product which you cannot monitor or which you cannot write your script for. Okay, so in that case, you will have to use, if you want to do column by column check, then you have to use Veridata. There are some third party product available. I cannot guarantee their validity. whether they will be successful or not. But yeah, there are some third party, which means I haven't tried it, so I cannot comment on that part. But yeah, just to answer, yeah, there may be some third party products as well. Okay. And this performance metric server or heartbeat table are inbuilt. They are not paid, and it is recommended that you use them. So performance metric server and heartbeat table should always be used. Okay, one question from Samrat is, can I convert existing integrated replicate to parallel replicate? Yes, you can convert. There is no direct mechanism available, but yeah, you can convert your existing integrated replicate to parallel replicate. Now, Jamshed is asking what is difference between lag at checkpoint and time since checkpoint and infall command. So that part, I have a blog related to it available. That part, so you can check my blog, which is available on my LinkedIn. You can go to my profile and search for articles. There is one blog available, difference between time since checkpoint and lag at checkpoint. Or after the session, you can ping me or email me. I'll share the link, or I'll share the link upon once we are done with this. At the end of the session, I'll share the link for that as well. Okay. So, Golden Gate heartbeat table we discussed. Now, let us now focus on OGG Veridata. Okay. So, what is OGG Veridata? Let us discuss about it. So, Golden Gate Veridata, as I told you, it's a database in sync monitoring tool. So Oracle Golden Gate Veridata compares one set of data to another and identifies data that is out of synchronization. So Veridata compares your set of data with another. So it compares your source and target column by column and identifies whatever data is out of sync. Veridata supports high volume, 24/7 replication environment, where downtime to compare data set is not an option. So the another advantage with Veridata is, as I told earlier as well, you don't need to get your application downtime. So Veridata supports high volume 24/7 replication environments where downtime to compare data set is not an option, and it also takes care of any inside rows. By accounting for data that is being replicated by when a comparison takes place, Oracle Golden Gate Veridata can run concurrently with data transaction and replication while still producing an accurate comparison report. So this supports my statement I was telling just now. So you don't need any downtime. Veridata comparison can run even when your Golden Gate replication is up and running. It can run concurrently with data transactions and replication while still producing an accurate comparison report. Oracle Golden Gate Veridata will map column data types across different types of database automatically. So the major advantage with Veridata is not only it works with Oracle, it also works with heterogeneous databases. Like I think it supports 5 or 6 databases, DB2, it supports Informic, it supports MySQL, SQL Server, Oracle. These databases at least I know it supports. So it will Veridata will map column data types across different types of databases automatically, or you can map columns manually in cases where automatic mapping is not sufficient to accommodate format differences in a heterogeneous database environments. So what Veridata does for you is it can identify which column mapping it has to do. So like say for example on source you have department number, so it will automatically identify which column comparison it has to do. Now say for example if you want to manually do the mapping, if the column names are different or the data types are not same and Veridata is unable to identify automatically, so in that case you can manually map your columns as well. That is the advantage. So this is how your Veridata architecture looks like. So for installing Veridata, you need to have a WebLogic installed first. So Veridata sit on top of WebLogic. Okay, so on WebLogic you install your Veridata server, and then using Veridata server you conf on the Veridata server, you will configure your Veridata jobs, which will compare your source and target databases. It will compare your source and target database, as you can see in this diagram. So Veridata job, when you run, it connects to the your Veridata job connects to the source database as well as target database, comparing both the sites. And once it has identified the discrepancies, it will show you the report. And if you want to repair them, so repairing is not by default. If you want to repair them, like say, for example, you identify that those 1,000 rows are out of sync. So if you want to monitor it, well, if you want to repair it or manually, you can repair it as well. So now the question comes, why do we need Oracle Golden Gate Veridata? Why there could be data discrepancies in your environment? So top reasons we see why data goes out of sync, human error. So there can be some human error which can creep in your environment. Then source data is unknowingly corrupted. So you inherited, so your source data is unknowingly corrupted if it gets corrupted. So you inherited bad data, or out of bound globalization characters and bad data becomes nulls during DB copy. Target data is accidentally deleted or modified outside replication. So DBAs or application team manually run up insert, update, delete on target. Or no logging is set for source transactions. So Golden Gate captures the data from the transaction logs. Now for getting the data returned into transaction logs, they should be returned into transaction logs. So the object should be in logging mode. Now say for example, for doing the heavy transaction, application team manually convert them to no logging mode. So in that case, again, data will not be replicated. So data between source and target will go out of sync. Gaps during data instantiation, that could be another issue. Right, then application upgrades not coordinated between source and target, that could be another issue that may cause your Golden Gate to go out of sync. So now the question comes, why Oracle Golden Gate Veridata? What are the professional or personal reasons for it? Why should this Veridata be used? So currently there are cloud migrations going on. So upon cloud migrations, organizations want to confirm whether their data is in sync or not. Now to check whether their data is in sync or not, they need to ensure that they need to ensure before they can do the switch from on-prem to cloud, the application switch, they need to ensure that both the databases are in sync or not. So either they do it manually, but manually, how can they do? They can just do the count check. Again, as I mentioned, count check is not the it can only be taken as an indicative measure, but cannot be a definitive measure. So hence, if you want to do row by row, column by column check, in that case, organizations are using it. Hence, there are a lot of organizations which are hiring only Veridata specialist, Veridata admins for their environment. Now it is very popular product to compare data real time. Minimal performance offset at DB level. Now the thing is, Veridata is a product which is external to database, and it does very it when it queries, it basically does the it query the source database. So we cannot say that it is a zero. The performance impact it has on the source database is zero. We cannot definitely say that. But the performance impact it has is very minimal as per the research has, as per the my analysis has shown. So I would say the performance offset which Veridata has on source database is really very minimal. Then mandatory for clearing Golden Gate certification. So if you are looking for Golden Gate certification as well, 10447, it contains around 15, 10 to 15% of questions from Veridata. So 7 to 10 questions from Veridata, from GG certification has Veridata questions. Then another thing is need not to write trouble some SQL scripts and don't need any application downtime as well. Then very easy to configure. And when you are going out for any job interviews or any Golden Gate support, your Golden Gate questions are only going to come from three: Oracle Golden Gate Classic Architecture, microservices, and Veridata. So if you know all three Golden Gate job or Golden Gate questions, whatever you face, they will be coming from these three only. So you are covered completely when you learn this. Okay, so let me quickly show you how Veridata environment looks like. So this is the Veridata environment. Okay. So this Veridata page, which you see, you just have to log into Veridata, and once you log into Veridata, it will give you the page where it will tell you what all jobs are configured in your environment, what all things are configured in your environment. So if you see here, the Veridata job which we have configured, it shows us what all. So say for example, I have multiple environments in my environment. So let me log into my server, and when I log in, I'll do some transactions between source and target. So for running the Veridata, I need WebLogic server to run. I need Veridata server to be installed. So everything has been done. And also we have to ensure that this, our listener, etc., are also running in our environment. We have to ensure about that as well. So once we log into the database, we'll do some transaction, and then we can run the compare on our between source and target. So Veridata gives you the GUI login, and it tells you what all transactions are out of sync in your Golden Gate environment. Okay, so in this video, what I'm running right now, I'm going to do some transactions between source and target. So I'll show it to you, and then you will get this result. Whatever transactions goes out of sync, it will show you the transactions which the jobs which are in sync, the tables which are in sync, it will show you, and tables which are out of sync also, those will be delivered to you. Okay. Okay, so now in this video, what I'm running right now, in this I created two tables, DEPT11 and DEPT_copy2. I ran the job, and it will show me that this table is out of sync. This table is out of sync. The reason being, I have done some transactions between source and target. And see, because my row here, this row was out of sync here, location column, it is showing it as out of sync over here. So basically, this, when you see this, my on source, I have this column as location column as India. So when everything is in sync, it will show it to me as green. When any of the job is out of sync in Golden Gate, it will show it to me as orange. So orange means the status, orange means it is out of sync. So which row is out of sync now? Department number row is out of sync. The row with department number 10 is out of sync. And which column is out of sync? Location column is out of sync. The location column on source is Canada, and on target it is India. And the one which it shows to you, it is out of sync. So let me go back. and show to you the transactions I have done over here. So this is the VM, which I also share with you during the training program. So I have a source schema. I'm connecting to PDB-1. Inside that, I have a table called as DEPT-11. So inside DEPT-11, we are going to do some transactions. So if I check, select, if I do select star from DEPT-11, I have a row called as 10 sales Canada. And I have a table which I have got as DEPT-11 underscore copy. If I check it, the row between source and target doesn't matches. Row between source and target doesn't matches in this scenario. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to run a Varidata check. So we can identify it's a one row. So in our case, it should not be an issue. Means identifying is not an issue. But consider you have a big environment. That's where you need Varidata. And how Varidata does this task for you? How Varidata will identify which rows are out of sync? That is very important for us to identify. See, data is everything. The tool means what GoldenGate claims is it replicates the data with zero data loss and it doesn't compromise with any data integrity. So here we have data integrity issues. On source, we have got Canada. On target, we have got India. So it's the data integrity issue right now. So with Varidata now, we'll run the Varidata job, we'll claim our Varidata job, and using that Varidata job now, we'll identify how it will identify that which rows are out of sync. Let us see that. So we'll go to Varidata page where we have Varidata configured. So in Varidata, we configured groups, which I have already configured. And inside groups, we have jobs configured. So the highest hierarchy is job. Highest hierarchy is job. And inside that, we have a group. And when we have created a group which compares DEPT-11 and DEPT-11 underscore copy. So the thing is, in Varidata, you can compare any table between different databases or in the same databases as well. Varidata works fine. It's not mandatory for you. So you can configure your source and target connections in Varidata, which identifies which database it has to connect to. So basically through the connections it identifies. So it's not an issue whether you want to connect to source database or you want to connect to the target database. Now this job, what we are going to do is we are going to run this job now. We have already run this job. So once we run this job, upon running this job, on the left side, we can click on, it will go to running jobs. Now, if we cannot find, once the job finishes, it will move to finish job list. So now we see that once we configure, once we run the job, so how to run the job? You go to run execute job on the left side, select the job over here, whichever job you want to run. So then select inside job, you have various compare pair list. Identify which compare pair you need to run and then you can run the job. So top hierarchy include job. Inside job, you have groups and inside groups, you have compare pair. So once you run the job, once you execute the job, it will move to running job list. It will move to running job list. And once the job has run successfully, it will move to finished job list. So now if you see here, the job has moved to finished job, but what I see is it has failed. So the thing is right now it is not listing out whether it is successful or not. So it says connection refused error is there because the source or target connection is not established. So it says connection refuse. So the thing is, because here the listener is down, so that's why you face that issue. So once I resolve that listener issue, and then when I run it, I get this job has finished. So upon resolving that listener issue, and then when I check, the finished job, I see that one job is listed as finished, and I see one job is shown here as out of sync. Now, when I run this out of sync report now, when I will run this out of sync report now, I will get which, how many rows are out of sync. So it gives me that one row is out of sync. Okay. And then which row is out of sync, to identify which row is out of sync, you can check this row. So the row which is out of sync is department number 10, department number is sales. And the column which is out of sync in this particular row is location column. Now, by default, it doesn't run repair automatically. If you want to run the repair, you see this run repair option. So that run repair option by default is not enabled. You have to enable it. There are certain privileges or certain things you need to do to enable it. So if you want to repair it, when you run this run repair, automatically it will repair this row and get your target database or target row in sync with source row. So basically, your target row will become same as source. So the column will change to India, will change to Canada as well. Okay. So this is how your Veridata works. So Oracle GoldenGate Veridata involves several components. Like you need Oracle GoldenGate Veridata server. So for running the Veridata, you need a WebLogic server. Veridata sits on top of Veridata. So Veridata server performs the following functions. It coordinates the execution of Oracle GoldenGate Veridata tasks. Like we saw those groups, those compare pairs, everything, whatever we saw, right? Those runs on actually on the Veridata server. So Veridata server does the task of running the jobs, coordinating the jobs for you, execution data, execution of tasks. Then it sort the rows. It compares the data. It confirm out of sync data. So whatever data is out of sync, it confirms that. And it produces a report for review, as we saw. Then you have web Veridata web user interface. Veridata web user interface is what you are seeing. So what is happening on Veridata server, you are seeing on Veridata web user interface. So web user interface is a web browser, is a browser-based graphical user interface for these activities like configure comparison objects and rules, initiate comparison. So you initiate the comparisons from GUI. Review status and output of comparison. You can review out of sync data as well. Then you have agent as well. Now what happens is Veridata server is installed on one intermediate server, as I told you. So Veridata server resides on one intermediate server. Say for example, you have 100 database and you want to do the comparison of those 100 databases. So what you do is you identify one server where you will be installing Veridata. So that will be called as Veridata server. And to establish the connectivity with Veridata server to each database, you need to have Veridata agent installed on each database server. So Veridata agent executes the following database request on behalf of Oracle GoldenGate Veridata server. So Veridata agent is nothing but it's a middleman between Veridata server and databases. So it helps in establishing the connectivity between source and target databases. It fetches and return blocks of rows to compare. It return column level detail for out of sync. Now, how Veridata compares the data? Oracle GoldenGate Veridata relies on unique identifier to order rows for comparison. So, Veridata for comparison, Veridata needs some keys for row, keys for that. Okay. So Veridata relies on unique identifier. So you need to have either primary key, unique key, or you need to define some user-defined key. So if there is primary key, Oracle GoldenGate Veridata will use the primary key. If there is no primary key defined, then it will use smallest unique index. If you don't have primary key or unique key, you can define your user defined keys as well. Okay. Then there are various stages of comparisons which Varidata does. So like initial comparison step or confirmation step. So what happens is Varidata job when it executes, it identifies what rows are out of sync currently. So that is known as initial comparison step. And then when it shows you on the screen what all rows are out of sync, that is shows you after it has performed the confirmation step. So upon verifying, upon doing the confirmation, then only you get the confirmation that these rows are out of sync. So these are the two phases. First is initial comparison step and second is confirmation step, which happens. Now, what are the installation requirement for Varidata? So Varidata needs JDK, latest JDK is needed, certified JDK, of course, that should be certified. Then you need to install WebLogic server and then you need to install Varidata. Then what are the administrator users and roles available? Like there are certain, so GUI, when you see, not everyone can have permission to create users or create jobs, create groups or execute the jobs. So some users you may just want to identify, some users should only be able to monitor Oracle Golden Gate Varidata environment as well. So there are different roles and users available, like Varidata administrator, Varidata power user. These are the two powerful roles available in Varidata. So they can create new users, they can execute jobs, they can create jobs, create groups, everything they can do in Varidata environment. Then Varidata report viewer, it can only report, view the report or monitor the Varidata environment. Detail report viewer, again same. Then report operator and command line user, those are another views, another privileges which you may need. So repair operator means if the repair privilege is granted, then only you can run the repair. Then Varidata command line user is, you can run these jobs not only from GUI, you can run it from command line as well. To run it from command line, you need to have this role available, Varidata command line. This should be granted to the Varidata user. So for configuration, you need to have data source connection. Okay, then you need to create the groups for here. So data source connection means on, so between source and target, whatever connections you need to create, those connections should be created. So defining your source and target databases. Then groups, it is a container for compare pairs. So whatever compares you need to, whatever objects you need to compare, those are defined under compare pairs. And then compare pairs are provided under groups. Then compare pair mapping, source and target table you define under compare pair. Then jobs are unit of work. So basically you execute the job when you execute at Varidata level. And profiles are the runtime parameters which are assigned to each job or group. So two critical performance factors for Oracle Golden Gate Varidata include how data is sorted and how the data is sent across the network. That is really very important. Okay, so these are the really very critical performance factors for Oracle Golden Gate Varidata. So Golden Gate Varidata performance is really very important based on data sorting as well. So data sorting between source and target should be done properly, and how the data is sent over the network. That is another key important thing. So one question which is being asked is, as Varidata monitor row level, does it impact DB performance? I think I have already answered that. How does Varidata connect to database? Using that, you have to define the data source connection, and any connection which needs to be done through database, of course, it will be done through listener. Okay. At what basis job is created in Varidata? Again, you need to define compare pair. So we discuss about that in detail. Due to time constraint, this way, I just needed to give you the overview. So this is a detailed thing which we can discuss during the course. Okay, now Jamshir is asking, how can we identify that replication lag is due to network lag or due to replication process is unable to cope up with changes coming from source? So that again is dependent on, if it's a network lag, then the lag will be due to distribution server or data pump lag. So check the lag at their end at the data pump level. If you see it's high, then that means it's a network lag. Now, if it's due to replication process, it will be shown at replicate lag. If it's due to the capture process, then it will be shown at the extract lag. Okay. What is overhead that is added to database when we use Veridata? So there is no quantitative measure for that, but yes, there, as I told you, there is a, see, any tool which is external to the database, you cannot say that it will have zero impact. And I will never claim that. Even if Oracle claims it, I will deny it. It's not a zero overhead tool, but yeah, the performance offset, again, as per my experience, I'm telling you, the performance offset it has at the database level is very minimal. Like you will feel, see, the performance offset it has is very minimal, but the value it provides, it's really very high in comparison. Okay. So what is difference between power user and administrator? I think administrator can create the user for you. Power user only difference is, I'm not sure. I think it cannot create user if I'm not wrong. That is the, I'll have to read about it. I don't recall what is the exact difference between power user and administrator. Generally, by default, when I create user, so by default, it is created as administrator user. Okay. Okay. So guys, I'm launching a full-fledged 10 to 12 hour course from Oracle GoldenGate Veridata, which starts from beginning and covers up to advanced level to the expert level, starting from upcoming Saturday, 24th of July. It's a weekend batch, and it will pave your path towards becoming Oracle GoldenGate Veridata specialist. So it includes everything in detail, like we start with download and installation of GoldenGate, download the software, download the JDK, Veridata installation is discussed, then configuring Veridata, how to configure Veridata user, WebLogic user for Veridata, what is RCU, which is repository schema, then domains of Veridata, how to deploy agents, how to confirm what all, if you have multiple sources and targets available, so how do you deploy agents on multiple targets, how to start WebLogic server, how to start Veridata server, verify the agent connection, then data source connection, so Veridata administrator users and roles will be creating, then connection to the source and target database, then setting up GoldenGate Veridata compare pairs, creating jobs, creating groups, configuring and running jobs, troubleshooting issues, identifying and repairing the discrepancies. We'll be discussing how to repair the discrepancies. Then tuning and troubleshooting and performance of Veridata. So what are the tuning parameters you can use? What, how to improve Veridata performance, how to set up profile, troubleshooting. Everything is covered in detail in this training. So apart from that, I offer training course on classic architecture, microservices, and Veridata as well. So Veridata is starting from 24th of July. So you can access the course content from below link. Let me share it in the chat window. So you can access all the course content, all training course content from the link which I have shared with you. So that you can check my LinkedIn. So I have been conducting this training for long time, and there have been a lot of success stories and training feedbacks. So you can check, many are available on my LinkedIn. Also, these are the few feedbacks, one of the few of the many feedbacks which I have pasted over here. So you can check it on my LinkedIn profile as well. There are a lot of feedbacks available over my LinkedIn profile as well. Let me log into my LinkedIn profile. So you can access my LinkedIn profile to check the feedbacks as well. Okay, so here are some of the feedbacks which you can go through. Also, few feedbacks are available on my YouTube channel as well. You can go through the feedbacks over there as well. So all the training starts from basics and covers up to advanced level, and a lot of students are able to clear the certification, and they are supporting their job environment. Everything is getting done regularly. So Oracle GoldenGate Veridata batch is starting from 24th of July. Microservices batch will start from 14th of August. And one of the classic architecture batch, 30-day learning challenge, which if you're not available, just for your reference, it is in progress. Right now, it started last week. It started from 5th of July. So it is already in progress and next will start from next month onwards. So the batches are conducted alternatively on weekends and weekdays. So weekend batch is conducted on Saturdays, 7:30 a.m. and it's 3 hours a week session weekend batch and weekday batch. So the weekend batch timing is as per Eastern timing, it is 7:30 a.m. and as per IST, Indian timing, it is 5 p.m. Weekday batch is conducted during evening time, US Eastern time, 9:30 p.m. and 7 a.m. Indian timing. So Monday to Thursday as per US timing and as per Indian timing, Tuesday to Friday, 4 to 5 hours a week. Okay. So these are the few FAQs from trainees which I have listed. So what if I miss a live session? So with the training, you have 1 year unlimited retakes, lifetime access to session recordings. You have step-by-step activity guides, one-on-one doubt clearing session, job support for lifetime WhatsApp support, lab setup kit for practice you will be receiving. So sessions are conducted regularly. So with the training, you also have this lifetime WhatsApp support. So I have enrolled students WhatsApp group where other students of mine are there. So what happens is you learn from others and others learn from you. So you will be added to the WhatsApp group. You can ask your questions. So basically it's a collective learning as well. And it keeps you motivated as well. Along with that, you have lifetime on job support. So any technical issues related to GoldenGate you are facing at your workplace, you have lifetime on job support. You have 1 year unlimited retakes. That means you can join any session with me for next 1 year, any number of times. So I conduct this Veridata batch almost 2 to 3 times a year. Microservices 4 to 6 times a year. Classic 6 to 8 times a year. So you can join any session with me for next 1 year, any number of times. You have lifetime access to session recordings. So you have access to step-by-step activity guides, one-on-one doubt clearing sessions, lab setup kit for practice. So everything is provided to you. So setups sessions are conducted regularly. All the sessions are practical and training is interview and job oriented. You can join any session any number of times for next 1 year. All the sessions are live and interactive, and the session will pave your path towards becoming GoldenGate expert. So at the end of session, I assure you will be able to set up, manage, troubleshoot, configure GoldenGate on your own, as well as able to design and provide solution related to GoldenGate on your own to your customer. So if you're interested to join upcoming session, you can fill out the below inquiry form or you can email or WhatsApp me as well for any detail. So for reaching out to me, you can email me at ashishagarwalag@gmail.com and you can WhatsApp me at this number +1 416 871 5708 as well. So I'll paste this link as well over the chat if you want to go through it. Okay. So I would request you to provide today's session feedback. So guys, I hope today's session was informative and useful. So I thrive on your feedback. I request for your feedback and I thrive on providing the best training webinar. So what next topic you would like me to cover? So please provide your feedback for the session via email. Recommend me over LinkedIn or Twitter. So you can email me at ashishagarwalag@gmail.com. You can DM me over my LinkedIn profile. You can WhatsApp me or you can tweet me at ashishagarwalag. And don't forget to like and subscribe my YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/ashishagarwal_gg. For any post session queries, if you have, same, drop an email at ashishagarwalag@gmail.com or tweet or drop a comment on my YouTube, WhatsApp, or you can send a message over LinkedIn. Okay. So I hope, guys, today's session was informative and useful. On that note, I would like to thank all of you to take out your time to join this session. And one thing I would say, stay safe, guys. Stay in these tough times and keep growing, keep learning. Thank you for joining the session. Thank you very much.